to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about 5 spring trends that I'm going to be getting into this season and even into summer. So make sure that you keep watching to find out what those spring trends are going to be. And also make sure that you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know when I've uploaded a new video. Also come visit me on Instagram and TikTok. That's where I'm going to be styling these trends. So if you want to see more visuals on that, then make sure you come say hi. Also guys, before we get started, I'm dealing with pink eye right now. That's why I have my glasses on and I'm not wearing any makeup. I haven't been able to wear makeup for like the past week. So just bear with me and my red eye. I'm on antibiotics and it's just, she's a vibe. So anyway, let's get into the video. First trend is actually a combination. So it's mermaid core and siren core. First thing that I think of when I think of siren core is Mirapolay. They have like definitely cornered the market on this type of trend and I live for it. I am so obsessed with the silhouettes and the styles and like the dark feminine energy that comes from their pieces. And I was actually at the show this past fall and literally my life was changed after watching it. I was just like, okay, I will never think of personal style the same way again, but in the best way possible. The reason why I wanted to combine that is because I see a lot of similarities with the two trends. Some influences that I've seen that sort of embody these two cores is like Lana Del Rey. I think we've all seen that photo of her in a Mirapolay outfit. It's like a perfect mix of sensuality and divinity that I'm like, okay, I didn't think those things could be put together, but luckily I was proved wrong and now I can start implementing those types of styles into my own personal style. So it's just super exciting and inspiring to see that these two worlds can come together. Something that I think is like quintessential mermaid core are these pieces from Work at the Beach Be Like. I saw them on Instagram a while ago, like pre-fall fashion week, and I was like, what? These are insane because they're all custom made sets and they are just like quintessential mermaid core, like bright pastel colors like corals and turquoise, and I'm like, this is just everything. But it's so hard to get a piece from them because it's just like it's all made to order and she does like selective drops, so like you gotta be quick with it. I've been seeing pieces that, you know, kind of coin these trends with Pan Official or Sun Iris. Fabrics I've been seeing are crochet, ruffles. Fancy Club has kind of, it's like Fancy Club's domain. Like their ruffle mesh dresses are just like, it's giving upscale jellyfish. Like I love it though, I live. So I'm also seeing metallic and silk blends that are kind of giving like the illusion of like a wet look. I've also been seeing like shell necklace and like pendant necklaces. So we're kind of moving away from our like essentials stack, which I'm like wearing right now. I wish I was wearing my pendant necklace because I've been wearing that nonstop, and hearts are actually another big trend that we're going to be seeing, not just in clothes but mostly in accessories. So I've been seeing like heart chokers, heart necklaces, and another big accessory trend that I've been seeing are the 3D flowers. So like, just if you go to Michael's and you buy like ribbon or string, like they're fake flowers, and you just super glue it onto the string and like wrap it around your neck, like that's, You're trending, girl. I've been seeing 3D flowers, not just in accessories, but also on clothing. So like I mentioned before, Fancy Club, they have like their ruffle details, but they also have like 3D flowers coming out. I've also been seeing them very much exaggerated on the runway, but just, we're talking about the realistic trends here. So yeah, that's not my domain. I like seeing things that inspire me and actually being able to wear them in real life. My second trend is actually a prediction. I'm calling it glossy core because I've been seeing all these concept stores from all parts of the world that just sort of have the same thing. Like they're not just apparel, but they have like homeware, they have mugs, they have journals, they have like all these little things like phone cases. Their imagery is just so like glowy, golden hour, sunset, summer vibes, and I'm here for it. That's probably what I'm going to be wearing on a day-to-day basis because it's just my favorite thing. It's my favorite vibe. And some of the brands that you can totally look into, I've already been following them for a while and I love all their pieces. Like I'm planning to just have my entire wardrobe just be from these brands. but the biggest one is BST Loves You. I actually bought this like I don't know how long ago, but this is just so cute. It just says like this song reminds me of you, and I'm like, how freaking cute is that? Like, I'm about trends that like exhibit a vibe. Concept stores like this, I'm like, this is so cute. Anything with like a cute little text on like a graphic tee or a phone case or a mug, I'm like, I'm here for it. If I were a glossy core girl, I'd be wearing like Brandy Melville, this new brand that I don't know if they're new. They've probably been around for a while, but they're new to me because I just discovered them. So Capri the label, so freaking cute. BST Loves You, In My Moods, Sheriff Avenue. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know I've mentioned Matilda Sheriff plenty of times, so you must be familiar with her store. If you're not, go check it out because she has the cutest basics and graphic tees, and she even has like bedding and homeware, and it's just the cutest concept ever. Like, I think I'm so attached to these types of stores because I want to own a store like this at some point in my life. So yeah, that's why I'm like, I'm making it a core. I'm making it a trend because one day it's gonna be my turn. And then some other brands would be from Kidney, Cuckoo Intimates, Pretties, RUMI, Poster Girl, and Enduring Kairos. Kairos? I'm sorry if I pronounced that wrong. A lot of brands that are sustainable, slow fashion, concept stores, that is still in development. We'll see how it evolves. If it does, if anything, it'll just be my own little aesthetic. I don't need an aesthetic, I am the aesthetic. That type of energy. Third trend is a belly core. Okay, another one that I predicted, so that's your credibility right there, that I'm pretty on point with predicting these trends. Just saying. Anyway, the way that I've seen belly core evolve is into Pink Pilates Princess. I think that that's super cute. Of course, belly core is still going strong. So some pieces that I mentioned before in my previous trend videos are pieces like boleros, ribbons, leg warmers, wrap skirts, oversized tote bags. I've seen this one bag from My Mom Made It. It's like the oversized quilted bag. Another big example, like what I'm wearing right now, she's from Pretties, in case you wanted to know, is pointtail. I'm obsessed, not just for pajamas, because usually I think pointtail was mainly just for pajamas, but now that people are wearing pajamas a lot more, like thank you Bella Hadid for making this okay. But now that we're seeing like pointtail in like day-to-day wear, I'm so excited for that. I've also been seeing examples from Rat Boy, which is so cute. They have these like bolero tube tops with like a cute little dainty flower in the center. So cute. I've been seeing a lot of people styling Rat Boy, and I'm obsessed because I found them last year, and yeah, I still have my pieces to this day, and I plan to get way more. Frankie's Bikinis also has some really cute pieces for the belly core aesthetic. They're a little more pricey, which is really sad, but I think it's totally valid if like these are part of your personal style. If you want to invest in some pieces that are really good quality and are just the original, then you know, go for it. You can also thrift, like that's totally another option too. You could probably find some really cool one-of-a-kind pieces, or you could shop the brands that I mentioned too that are like made to order. They have very like small drop, and go that route. It's really up to you. But just saying, like for the ones that are like a little more pricey and you're kind of like debating, just think about it, sleep on it, and if it's really part of your personal style, if you're still thinking about it, I say get it. Yeah. Also, like Depop, I know that like a lot of people resell Frankie's Bikinis on Depop, so definitely keep an eye out for that. I know that I am. My fourth trend for you guys are elevated basics. What is there to say about elevated basics? I mean, they're just something that's always going to be trending. It's not really something that is new to anyone. I just think that we're seeing different types of silhouettes and fits. Sorry guys, the lighting just decided to go full emo on me. Okay. Elevated basics. It has definitely sort of broadened the scope of how we can interpret basics. So, you know, for a while it was trousers, for a while it was cargo. Now it's whatever you want it to be. And I am scared, genuinely, that everyone's been talking about bringing skinny jeans back, and I'm like, that's fine, go ahead and do that. I am personally not subscribing to that. At least not now. Not at the current point in my life, because I'm not into lying to myself and saying that I'm comfortable when I'm not. Another elevated basic that we've been seeing a lot are maxi skirts. Because I'm short, I thought that I couldn't really style maxi skirts or even midi skirts, but now the more that I'm wearing it, the more that I'm like styling it with different types of tops, I'm actually really into the maxi skirts, especially the pointelle maxi skirts that I have. Like, I love those. Also, headbands. Love headbands, like the sporty ones. I know that I saw like a recent trend video that talked about the thinner, like more structured headbands, but personally, I wear those for 15 minutes and get a headache, so I'm not really about those headbands. I'm definitely more about the sporty, thick headbands. I think those look super cute. Jeff Avenue actually has this one headband that's like this cute like pastel like candy core. Another prediction, but I'm not gonna get into that one today. Candy core aesthetic. It's just giving like that bubblegum that I would get as like a 5-year-old that was like had like the zoo animals on it and stuff. I don't know what it was called, but basically just pure sugar on a stick. It just like that pattern reminded me of it, and I'm like, I need it. It reminds me of my childhood. Tops that I think we're veering into are more full-length tops, especially since low-rise has become so popular. So I think that we're going to be seeing more full-length tops, but with like open backs. I've been seeing this one top from Amazon just like blow up. I think you guys all know of it. It's like that short sleeve top. I'm so sorry for this landing, guys. Short sleeve top that is completely backless in the back. It's perfect for siren core, ballet core, glossy core, all those things. Definitely love seeing full length tops like that. And then some brands that I think have really good basics, and they all range from like pretty reasonable to more expensive, but you really get the quality from that. Jeff Avenue, Garage, Aritzia, Abercrombie, In My Moods, Princess Polly, Naked, and Brandy Melville all have really good basics. So depending on your budget, you can look into any of those. My fifth trend for you guys is motocross and utility wear. So I feel like I've been talking about this one for a while too, because it's been around for a while, especially the racer jackets, like the oversized, advertisements all over it, very bright colors, like either like red or blue, green, and like all different materials from like cotton to leather. We've been seeing that for a while, and I think this fall we've sort of refined that into more like fitted motocross jackets, and I love it. I have my jacket from Lucan, and I get questions about it all the time because it's just a very nice, simple motocross jacket with like the button neck. I think that that is something to pair with like a low-rise mini skirt, maxi skirt, some boots. Out of all of these trends, the best combo that I've seen is the motocross with ballet core. I think that looks so cool. I'll include some pictures that I've seen of like two worlds coming together with like ribbons, leather, boots, a wrap skirt, leotard, just like stuff like that. It's just giving such baddie core vibe. Okay guys, so those are all the trends that I have for you today. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and comment below what your favorite trend was that I mentioned, or if you have a separate trend that you want to talk about, I am all here for it. I'll definitely be styling these types of pieces on my Instagram and TikTok, so make sure that you go check that out. And I will see you in my next video. Bye!